Holy Mass here on this beautiful sunny Sunday. We're grateful for student participation at Mass, helping out with some of the aspects of our prayer today. So we're always grateful for our families and our faith formation students and our teachers and volunteers who help with that. Please join in our opening song as you are able today. Here I am, Lord. Here I am, Lord. Number 383. 383. Here I am, Lord. And a reminder, you're always welcome to pick up a Breaking Bread hymnal. Keep it with you for the coming year and can follow along with our scriptures and our songs as you are able. 383.
Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you always.
And with your spirit.
And this morning, we hear in our first reading the boy Samuel, 11 years old, saying, "Here I am." You and I, no matter what age we are, we too are to open our hearts and say, "Here I am," to the Lord, to follow him in the ways of love and mercy, truth and peace. Knowing at times that we sin and we need the Lord, let us acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and what I have failed to do. Through my most grievous fault. Therefore, I ask Blessed Mary, ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Please follow along as you are able with our Gloria, number 922. 922.
Glory to God, glory to God, glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace, on earth peace to people of good will. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you, we give to God, glory to God in the highest, and on earth, peace to people of good will. Lord Jesus Christ, only begotten Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. You take away the sins of the world, receive our prayer. You are seated at the right hand, the right hand of the Father, have mercy on us. Glory to God, glory to God, glory to God in the highest, and on earth, peace to people of good will. For you alone are the Holy One, you alone are the Lord, you alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father. Glory to God, glory to God, glory to God in the highest, and on earth, peace to people of good will. Amen. Amen. Let us pray. Almighty, ever-living God, who govern all things both in heaven and on earth, mercifully hear the pleading of your people and bestow your peace on our times. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
A reading from the first book of Samuel. Samuel was sleeping in the temple of the Lord, where the ark of God was. The Lord called to Samuel, who answered, "Here I am." Samuel ran to Eli and said, "Here I am, you called me?" "I did not call you," Eli said. "Go back to sleep." So he went back to sleep. Again the Lord called Samuel, who rose and went to Eli. "Here I am," he said, "you called me?" But Eli answered, "I did not call you, my son. Go back to sleep." At that time, Samuel was not familiar with the Lord, because the Lord had not revealed anything to him as yet. The Lord called Samuel again for the third time. Getting up and going to Eli, he said, "Here I am. You called me?" Then Eli understood that the Lord was calling the youth. So he said to Samuel, "Go to sleep, and if you are called, reply. Speak, Lord, for your servant is listening." When Samuel went to sleep in his place, the Lord came and revealed his presence, calling out as before, "Samuel, Samuel." Samuel answered, "Speak, for your servant is listening." Samuel grew up, and the Lord was with him, not permitting any word of his to be without effect. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Said I, "Behold, I come."
A reading from the first letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians. Brothers and sisters, the body is not for immorality, but for the Lord. And the Lord is for the body. God raised the Lord and will also raise us by his power. Do you not know that your bodies are members of Christ? But whoever is joined to the Lord becomes one spirit with him. Avoid immorality. Every other sin a person commits is outside the body, but the immoral person sins against his own body. Do you not know that your body is a temple of the Holy Spirit within you, whom you have from God, and that you are not your own? For you have been purchased at a price. Therefore, glorify God in your body. The word of the Lord.
Jesus Christ, who brings us truth and grace. Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia. The Lord be with you.
A
reading from the Holy Gospel according to John. John was standing with two of his disciples, and as he watched Jesus walk by, he said, "Behold the Lamb of God." The two disciples heard what he said and followed Jesus. Jesus turned and saw them following him and said to them, "What are you looking for?" They said to him, "Rabbi," which translated means teacher, "where are you staying?" He said to them, "Come and you will see." So they went and saw where Jesus was staying, and they stayed with him that day. It was about 4 p.m. Andrew, the brother of Simon Peter, was one of the two who heard John and followed Jesus. He first found his own brother Simon and told him, "We have found the Messiah," which is translated Christ. Then he brought him to Jesus. Jesus looked at him and said, "You are Simon, the son of John. You will be called Cephas," which is translated Peter. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise
to you, Lord Jesus Christ. In the words of the Gospel, wipe away our sins. Here I am, Lord, I come to do your will. And we hear this theme of here I am, here I am, here I am, and the mystery of what it means to say that. So we know the Lord works in mystery. Mystery, meaning we can't know everything about something, but we can know something about a particular way that God works. And so one of those mysterious workings was a week ago. I had the opportunity to have the early Mass in Hastings, Nebraska, and then I was traveling on my way to Atchison, Kansas. And so I thought, hey, along the way there's a 10:30 Mass in Marysville, Kansas. I'll just stop in there and just pray with the people, pray with the people. And so I show up about 3 minutes before Mass, which is
not my usual way, and I slip in the back, and I'm like, oh, this will be great to hear a different preacher, gain some great insights, be spiritually edified and strengthened. And the priest enters in, we're all singing, and I look and see, you've got to be kidding me. Father Brendan Rowling from my hometown of Ivanhoe, Minnesota. So he's a Benedictine priest out of Atchison, Kansas, and he was given the mission appeal that weekend. Small world. So after Mass, I went up to him and said, Father Brendan Rowling. He's like, what are you doing here? I'm like, no, what are you doing here? So we took a selfie together and sent it to our mothers, who are best friends. So really wild. Mystery, mystery, mystery is all over the Here I Am, Lord. Here I Am, Lord. This morning in our first reading, it's great that we have our children here participating in the Mass. Are there any 11-year-olds here this morning? Anybody who's 11? You get a special prize if you're 11 and present, all right? So what's wild is in our first reading, we have Samuel. He's 11 years old. He's an 11-year-old boy. And you got to know a little bit of something about Samuel and his life. And that is his parents, Elkanah and Hannah, they had been trying to have children for years and years and years and weren't able to. They weren't able to have children, and it was a great sorrow for them. And they prayed and said, Lord, if you would bless us with a child, we will consecrate that child to you and for your service. And so, again, mystery of mysteries, God blessed Hannah and Elkanah with a child, Samuel. And so they dedicated Samuel to the Lord, and in their dedicating of him to the Lord, they brought him to the temple that he would be there for service in the temple, in that special place in Jerusalem. And so under the care of Eli the priest and under his tutelage there at the temple, it is there that Samuel, that he grew up. But he wasn't fully aware of how the Lord works, how he speaks, how he communicates to his people in the very small but significant ways. And so as this 11-year-old boy slept, he was awoken in sleep. And as he was awoken, he thought it was Eli, the priest, who he was learning from. And so he went over to that priest, Eli, here I am, here I am. Eli, waking from sleep, go to sleep, Samuel. Go to sleep. What are you doing? Go to sleep. But you called me. I did not call you. Go to sleep. So Eli goes and tells Samuel to go back to bed. Samuel, the boy, is woken up again. Goes over to Eli. He does that two more times. Finally, Eli, the priest, realizes no one's waking up Samuel except for God. God is speaking to this boy. And it's there where these very beautiful words are told by Eli. He says to him, if that happens again, say, speak, Lord, for your servant is listening. Speak, Lord, for your servant is listening. This is excellent for the next time that Samuel is woken that night by the Lord. He says, speak, for your servant is listening. And it is there that Samuel realizes that God is speaking to him and that his life has been touched by God. And in being touched by God, that Samuel's life will be set apart for the service and for the glory of God. On this weekend, for you and I, brothers and sisters, this is good news, because you and I, in the mystery of God's plan, that we are called to follow him. We are called to listen to the voice through our prayer and through our life of faith. And there are those that God puts on our path to help us to listen more to the voice of God and to follow him. You don't have to be just an 11-year-old boy to hear the voice of God, to figure out what your vocation or your calling is in life. But any of us in our life of faith are called to listen. And listening can be hard in our culture, which is fast-paced, electronically driven. The importance of being able, like Samuel the boy, to hear the voice of God, and then to have people like he had in his life to help him to discern that voice. It is there this last week I had the opportunity to be on retreat and to help out with the retreat for seminarians. And it is there that these young men who are studying for the priesthood in the Catholic Church, they have a beautiful desire to serve God and his people. And all of them in their lives of faith from different parts of the Midwest and Plain States, these particular men, that they had been listening to the voice of God and opening up their lives to service and hearing about their joys and their enthusiasm as well as their struggles and the ways that God is inviting them to grow and mature. It was very inspiring for my heart. It made me think of the first time that God really concretely called me to want to follow him as a priest. About 45 miles south and west of here is the booming metropolis of New Richland, Minnesota. It was there that I was helping with a confirmation retreat as a freshman at MSU Mankato. And I remember going to confession to the priest who was there at the time and sharing my heart and saying, I think God is calling me to become a priest. And he encouraged me. And it was from that time forward that I felt in my heart that powerful direction of God to say, here I am, Lord. I come to do your will. There are those in this parish, as I look out, who have been called to marriage and the sacrament of married life. There are those, as I look out, who have been called to a special vocation and single life by circumstance or by choice. There are those here, potentially our young people, who are called to priesthood, our young men. And for our young ladies, called to religious life, that we would open up our hearts and our lives to this call of God. But how important to be able to slow down to pray and to listen to the voice of the one who directs us. It isn't a one-time listening, but it is a lifetime. As I was reminded yesterday as I took a phone call from a woman from our area saying, I'm in a struggling marriage and my husband doesn't want to be a part of it anymore. But I said to him, when I took these vows with you, I meant it for life. I meant it for life, and may God help us in this time. Here I am, Lord. I come to do your will. God gives you and I the strength to live out our vocation. I have made the promises to be faithful to God in daily prayer, chastity, and obedience. For you, the vows and promises in married life are for those who are discerning a vocation to be faithful to your spouse, to be faithful to God for those in discernment mode. It is here that on this Sunday we take the opportunity to listen to the voice of God, to recognize those who point us to hear that voice, as John the Baptist did in our gospel. It wasn't about him, but rather he pointed to Jesus and said, "Behold the Lamb of God." And it was those like Peter and Andrew who heard and followed Christ. May you and I, may we take that time today in prayer and throughout our lives to listen to the voice of the one who is love and to be ready to say each day, here I am, Lord. With your help, I come to do your will. Together, let us profess our faith. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man.
For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day, in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy Catholic and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. Heavenly Father, on this Sunday, we offer to you our prayers and our petitions.
Please respond, Lord, hear our prayer for those who dedicate their lives to work of the church and for all who respond to the call of God. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the youth that are here today, may they grow in fullness of the Lord. Let us pray to the Lord. For the rightnesses who struggle against racism and violence, let us pray to the Lord.
For the members of this community who put their commitment into justice, into practical action, let us pray to the Lord. We hold in the silence of our hearts. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all who have died, especially Bridell, Gadiant, may they shine in the fullness of the resurrection. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray for those who are discerning their vocation, who are in our midst from our area parishes, discerning marriage, religious life, priesthood. We pray for this special time of discernment. We pray to the Lord.
Lord.
Heavenly Father, we are grateful for the power of your love. Help us to pray, to listen, and to respond. We make this prayer in all prayers through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
What do you want of me, Lord? Where do you want me to serve you? Where can I sing your praises? I am your song. Jesus, Jesus, you are the Lord. Jesus, Jesus, you are the way. I hear you call my name, Lord, and I am moved within me. Your spirit stirs my deepest self. Sing your songs in me. Jesus, all through me. Your spirit burns deep within me. Fire my life with your love. Jesus, Jesus, you are the Lord. Jesus, Jesus, you are the way.
Please stand and pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. The Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and good of all his holy church. Grant us, O Lord, we pray, that we may participate worthily in these mysteries. For whenever the memorial of this sacrifice is celebrated, the work of our redemption is accomplished through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For out of compassion for the waywardness that is ours, he humbled himself and was born of the Virgin. By the passion of the cross, he freed us from unending death, and by rising from the dead, he gave us life eternal. And so with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, and with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory, as without end we acclaim.
Holy,
holy, holy Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna, Hosanna, Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna, Hosanna, Hosanna in the highest. You are indeed holy, O Lord, and all you have created rightly gives you praise. For through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by the power and working of the Holy Spirit, you give life to all things and make them holy. And you never cease to gather a people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you, by the same Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts we have brought to you for consecration, that they may become the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For on the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me."
The mystery of faith.
When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again.
Therefore, Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the saving passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven, and as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray upon the oblation of your church and recognizing the sacrificial victim by whose death you willed to reconcile us to yourself. Grant that we who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son and filled with his Holy Spirit may become one body, one spirit in Christ. May he make of us an eternal offering to you so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with blessed Joseph, her spouse, with your blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, and with all the saints on whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for unfailing help. May the sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth, with your servant Francis, our Pope, and Bernard, our Bishop, Andrew, his assistant, the order of bishops, all the clergy, the entire people you have gained for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family whom you have summoned before you. In your compassion, O merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world, to our departed brothers and sisters, and to all who are pleasing to you at their passing from this life. Give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory. Through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good.
Through him and with him and in him, O God, almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen. Amen. Amen.
At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. Amen. The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take
mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Grant us peace.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. May the body of Christ keep me safe for eternal life. May the blood of Christ keep me safe for eternal life.
You have prepared a table before me, and how precious is the chalice that quenches my thirst. Thank you.
come to bring you home, to be one with him anew. I receive the living God, and my heart is full of joy. I receive the living God, and my heart is full of joy. Jesus said, I am the truth. If you follow close to me, you will know me in your heart, and my word shall make you free. I receive the living God, and my heart is full of joy. I receive the living God, and my heart is full of joy. Jesus said, I am the life, far from whom no thing can grow, but receive this living bread, and my spirit you shall know. I receive the living God, and my heart is full of joy. I receive the living God, and my heart is full of joy.
We are grateful Jesus Christ, for this opportunity to receive your blessing, to receive your body, blood, soul, and divinity in the Eucharist. And this week, as we have inauguration of President, as we remember the terrible decision to legalize abortion in our country and its effects, we pray, Lord Jesus, for your mercy. We pray for your peace. We pray that every person would be respected, that life would be cherished. The child in the womb, the disabled person, the elderly, those with chronic disease. Mother Mary, we implore your intercession for our country in this time. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. A few announcements. A reminder that on Thursday we have our leadership meeting here at St. Patrick at 6:30. Also in this time, this evening, for our area parishes, we have the final weeks here beginning tonight of our RCIA for those entering into the Catholic Church or who would like to enter into the Catholic Church at Easter. So there's still opportunity to join in, or for those who would like to learn more about the Catholic faith, starting tonight at 6 p.m. going through the Easter week. Also next week will be Doctors of the Church seminar, which is a 10-week seminar for those who would like to go deeper in their faith. That'll be held here at St. Patrick, 7 p.m. Sunday nights. For everyone in our area, we'll be going through the writings of St. Francis de Sales, in particular his Introduction to the Devout Life, basically practical spirituality for you and me, people going through regular life things. Also, we have an opportunity starting on the 14th or 15th of February, going through the 19th of March, anybody who would like to make the consecration to St. Joseph, and that will begin at that time. So it'd be nice to have like 100 or 150 or even more make the consecration to St. Joseph in this year of St. Joseph. So beginning tomorrow, I will start growing the St. Joseph beard. So this is the time. So what a blessing to be together. Thanks for all those who helped with the Mass, especially our young people, you know, doing the petitions today. How wonderful. You did a great job. So how about if we give a hand for our students? It's not easy to get up in front of people. If you can get that one figured out, God will be with you in many ways.
Let us pray. Pour on us, O Lord, the spirit of your love and in your kindness. Make those you have nourished by this one heavenly bread, one in mind and heart, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. The Mass is ended. Go in peace.
Thanks be to God.
Please join as you're able in our closing song, Glory and Praise to Our God. Glory and Praise to Our God, number 548.
Praise to our God, O Lord.
sons of him who built the valleys and plains. Praise the wonders our God has done in every heart that sings. Glory and praise to our God, who alone gives light to our days. Many things he bears to those who trust in his ways. In his wisdom he strengthens us like gold that's tested in fire. Though the power of sin prevails, our God is there to save. Glory and praise to our God, trust in his ways. Every moment of every day, our God is waiting to save. Always ready to seek the lost, to answer those who pray.